and empty. I got an aching way down inside. I need someone, someone to hold me. Pull down the shade, turn out the light, and love me tonight. Don't think about tomorrow, it don't matter anymore. We can turn the key and lock the world outside the door. I need you so now, come on, let go now. Kick off your shoes, turn out the light, and love me tonight. Your hair down, sit by my side, turn off the TV, put on some music, pull down the shade, turn out the light, love me tonight. Don't think about tomorrow, it don't matter anymore. We can turn the key and lock the world outside the door. Shoes, turn out the light and love me tonight.
Little Don Williams for you there, the gentle giant, as he was referred to, a man with, I guess, over 20 hit songs, all about love, one about not believing in organic food. That one's kind of controversial. How's it going, everybody? Oh, hey, it's my friend from Target. Hello. Is it Gemma or Gemma? Hi, Gemma. That was a big moment for me going to Target. I hadn't really done that yet. Kind of freaked me out, but I think it was worth it because I got two bikinis. And Gemma was there and we took a little picture by the bikini station. She clocked me in my mask. It was cool. I felt special. Gemma, it made me feel special that you recognized me in the Target. Let's see your mask. Good for you, girl. Let's see your mask. Which one? I mean, I got a plethora of masks. I got tie-dye masks. I got vote masks. Masks that say vote on them. I got kitty cat mask. I got a kid's mask. I don't wear that one, it's too small. That was a mistake. That was an impulse buy. Because now when I go out, rarely to the shops, which last time I saw you guys, I was only going to Staples. Jenny Lewis mask. Ooh, that's creepy. So yeah, only going to Staples. That was the only shop I went to for months because no one was in there. And I was just like spiraling out on the Sharpie section. Like everything was so, wow, all the things you can buy. You really miss that stuff, you know? Cow print mask is one I could see you in. Yeah, me too. I'd like one of those. Do you have an all sequins mask? No. Will someone make me one? Kind of a little fancy. Honestly, I haven't worn anything but, you know, sweats. And now this tracksuit, which is pretty cool. I'm gonna keep this. It's old school tracksuit. Got it at a Goodwill in Las Vegas. Have you tried the Sharpie pens? Are they the like tight kind of like, I like a Sharpie because it's fat. You know, like something that's like too small and precise, that's not my style. I like something kind of chunky. You're the one person who's been to Staples in the last decade, it's true. And let me tell you, they know about their printer ink over there. The sham of the modern world. Fucking printer ink. It's like, are you kidding me? So fucking expensive. But I need it, because I like to print stuff. I like to print stuff out. Just print it out. Just whatever it is, just print it out. Just tape it up on the wall. Working on a poem, just print it out. Tape it up on the wall. Throw it on the ground. Walk over the poetry. Walk over it. Step on the poetry. Put one in the bathroom. Hang it up. Remember your poem. Fuck printers. Rob, you're being very negative. What is you don't like printers? Oh, are you an eco guy? I get it. How many haircuts have you gotten? Just a tutorial from Jane, from Edo Salon. That was really like life, step on the fucking poetry. That's right, LSQ. Sorry, Tennessee is texting me. Love it. It's, anyway, I'll deal with that later. I don't think she's watching because she has a baby. Anyway. What was I talking about? Oh, who cares? Peace and love. That's Ringo's thing. Oh, Jane. I was talking about Jane. So, Jane gave me a tutorial on how to trim my bangs. It's on my Instagram movie section, wherever that is. And let me tell you, that is like a game changer, which I feel like this time at home has really allowed for some learning some skills, you know? For example, I was gifted 2 clone marijuana plants. They're legal in California, by the way. You can, up to 6 plants you can have legally. So my friend gave me 2 little clones that kind of look like this spider plant. And they grew into 2 monsters, 2 fucking monster plants that I cared for and looked after and eventually staked because the squirrels were ripping the stems and getting loaded out there, and they wanted to destroy the plant because they loved it so much. So I had to stake it up, and then I had to Velcro it to the stake, spray some natural squirrel repellent. Don't worry, it's clove and like, you know, spearmint. And then, you know, a couple months later, you've got 2 monster plants, and you're like, what am I supposed to do with this thing now that it is a monster? Do you play Mort Garson's Plantasia for your wheat? I do, actually. I play Mort Garson's Plantasia for all of my plants. Are you guys familiar with Mort Garson? He made an album, an early synthesizer record of like plant odes. There's an ode to a violet, I think. There's a spider plant one, which this is another plant thing, and I won't talk about plants the whole time, but like these things propagate like a motherfucker. Like they throw off these babies and then you just plant them. Oh, hang on, I'll show you. It's really interesting. BRB. So you get a spider plant and it throws off these little babies and you just trim them. And then you take the little bottom and you put them in a little jar like this and you fill it with water. This one doesn't have water in it. And you just let it, the roots will grow. And you can keep it in here for months, really, and then you transplant it into some soil. It's amazing. What the heck? I didn't know about this before 2020. No one told me about this. How is this so amazing? This thing will give you 1,000 plants. 1,000 plants. So anyway, this is, DM me if you need more info on this, but it's pretty straightforward. So there's that. And so I grew these monster weed plants that are really beautiful. And then it was time to harvest them, which, you have to cut these like giant stalks, which you basically feel like you're straight up fucking Rasta when you're hanging out with these plants. It's just like massive buds. And it's really sad to have to cut the plant down. And then my friend Jake Bellows, my best friend Morgan, her boyfriend, her partner, he taught me how to trim, which is really a long, cool process. And so you take the stalks off the plant, and then you do your trimming, and then you hang little strings, and then you let them dry, and then you continue to trim, and trim and trim and trim, 12 hours of trimming. And then after you trim, you end up with one of these. Wow. So you trim it out, you get rid of all the leaves, and then you do something called you nug it out. So you reduce it to the little nugs, and then you put it in a jar and you cure it, basically. So I'm learning how to cure this weed, which smells pretty good. And so you, when it's first in the jar, can you wish my dad Steve a happy birthday? Happy birthday, Steve. So when you put it in the jar for the first 3 days, you do something called you burp the jars. And you just give it air 3 times a day, and then you leave it alone. And then for a couple weeks, you just open it once a day, you burp it, and then it should be cured. I'm hoping, yeah, it's pretty amazing. Amazing stuff here in nature, you know? How's everyone doing out there? Happy birthday, Steve. Is this Steve's birthday? Have you guys co-opted my show for Steve's birthday party? Love all this terminology. Yeah, yeah, why, girl? The burping, isn't that interesting? Nugging out, burping, wow. There's a lot to be learned there. But I'm just gonna be a little bit, I don't wanna be like a narc or anything, but if it's not legal where you're at, just, you know, it's not worth it for weed. I would only do this because you can have 6 plants legally. Oh, I have a funny story though about, so, you know, the census is going around and you're supposed to be filling out your census forms. So I filled mine out. And there was like a follow-up woman that came to the door, and she had a clipboard, and she's like, hey, I was wondering about the house next door. Is anyone in there? You know, like asking questions. And I was like, oh yeah, you know, it's a rental, blah, blah, blah. And then she was like, what is that herb smell? What is that wonderful herb smell? And it was during the fires. And I was like, this lady's a fed. I'm not telling her it's weed. So I was like, oh, it's the smoke from the fires. She's like, no, it smells like an amazing herb. And I was like, well, it's probably the lavender out. And I never gave it up and I never told her, but that lady, she knows what's up. Maybe they'll put that in the census thing, right? Like, people grew hemp. Let's burp nugs. That's right, Boba Diaz. That's what I like to hear, Boba Diaz. Okay, so today I had a really cool day, but here at the house, yeah, another great day here by myself. Woo! Yeah! Great. Another day with me. Isn't the H silent in herb? Yes, you get the joke. I don't call it herb. I mean, I will now. I did have a stepdad called Herb. He was nice. Don't worry, he's still with us. Don't get so morbid. Are you taking requests? No. But I love you. Because I don't have like a huge databank for songs at one time. There's only like a couple in there. So congrats on the new old record. Oh, the Rilo Kiley one? Yeah, I don't know how to play any of those. Let's see. Yo, okay, so play Taffy. Oh, but I'll cry so hard. Okay. It's good that you're here. I can't see you, but I can feel you. Seriously. Oh. All right. Since I haven't talked to you, I dream about your baby blues and wonder why you start to get high. Even though we were just friends, I think of us as bookends and I'm gonna love you till I die. You think you're not a psycho, y'all. Just trying to get laid. What is the song? Psychos. It's called Psychos. It was my newest song before, but now it's not my newest song. I got other songs now. That one's old now. Psychos is one of my faves. Thanks. Yeah. Thank you. It was new, but now it's not new anymore. It's new to you. What's up, Callow Youth? Callow Youth? Callow Ute? All right, I'll play another newish one for you, if you're cool with that. What is the name of that song? Psychos. I'm a psycho. Michael, are you a psycho? Psychopath? Clinical? Have you guys looked up with regard to your own relationship? What are the traits of a psychopath? Or like sociopath? Don't you feel like everyone now shares like sociopath? Oh, he's a sociopath. He's a sociopath. Yo, you're going out with a sociopath. This is what a sociopath is. I'm an empath, but he's a sociopath. I mean, I'm sure they're out there, but I feel like maybe we're blanketing the, you know what I mean? Like, psychos. Yeah, no, that is actually, I'm not gonna get into it, but you know what I'm talking about. I mean, you could diagnose me probably with something. Uh-oh, hang on, let me fix this. It's not good. Woo, that was close. Wow. Okay, this one is called Essence. It has this line in it. Lean into the light, but sparkle blue. Oops. Wrong pedal. Yeah. Maybe it's time to go play the guitar. Let's go. Put on a little traveling music, shall we? All right.
I ran into an old friend of mine the other day. We hadn't seen each other for quite a while. What he had to say to me hit me pretty hard, because I think a lot of folks get started this way. He said, I thought it would be so easy, another one night stand. She seemed so warm and willing, right in the palm of my hand. It's 3 months ago last Wednesday since I woke up in her bed. Lord, I think I love her, but it scares me half to death.
Come on, let's go. Hey everybody, sorry for the delay. All right, welcome to Mint Chip Jam Room. This is, I'm not gonna say the thing they say on Cribs, but you know what I'm thinking, right? What am I thinking? Power stripping in the USA. All right. How's this view? Not bad? All right. How about we get a little closer? Let's get a little closer, right? And I can see what you guys are saying. All right. I wonder what Emily Albert is doing right now. I don't know. Maybe you should call her. Purdy Dan Electra, thank you. All right. Got this one.
You heard it before, sorry.
Sing along. Okay, hold on. Wait, how's it go? It's not time for the sexual connection. It's, bad habits. Bad habits will...
I'm gonna start it over. Let me start it over. Let me tune it up.
Why not? You guys love to watch people tune. Remember back in the day, you watch people tune all the time at shows? Tuning, nervously tuning. Now this is the rare opportunity. This is the tuning show. Oh, that's pretty good, actually. I think it's that capo that pulls this E out. Oh, that's bad. That's really bad, guys. Bad. Very bad. Oh, I'm embarrassed. Hold on. Something's happening. Oh, yeah, that was good. I got nervous and I tuned it one half step. Oh, gosh. A lot of practice. All right. Guaranteed this is going to sound worse. Guaranteed. All right, here we go. Let's see what you guys are saying here. Opportunity. Yeah. Yeah. Opportunity. Yell at that string. Yep. Will do. Will do, everybody. Will do.
Here's a song. We're going to try it again.
All right? You know this one. Maybe.
Down the rapid, oh, with you again, waiting.
doobie, y'all. Here's a doobie. Whatever. No, just kidding. Shout out to my dad. It's his birthday today. Happy birthday up in heaven, or wherever you are, sir. Happy birthday, Eddie Gordon. Oh, hey, check this out. I'll show you guys a pic of my pops. Oh, this is a great opportunity to demonstrate an instrument for you guys. So this is my dad here, Mr. Eddie Gordon. Let's see if we can see him there. See him, he's playing that big, big old harmonica. Those are some of his harmonica students. So, he's kind of a legendary guy. And he was gifted this instrument called the Millionizer, which is the world's only harmonica synthesizer, the Millionizer. So they made, I don't know how many they made, not many. Two went to my dad, or three, I have two of them. But it's pretty cool. It's got this mouthpiece, which I have no idea how to play. It's like a chromatic harmonica here. So let's see here if we can get this thing going. The Millionizer. Oh, okay, so this is on. All right, let's fire it up on Eddie's birthday. Happy birthday, Eddie. Busting out the Millionizer. It's a big deal. Is that a DVD player? This, no, it's a Millionizer mouthpiece. I wish I knew how to rip this thing, but let's try, shall we? Well, this is the pitch. It's kind of like that game Tron. Do you guys remember Tron? Okay, wait. How do you get a sound out of this thing? Okay, hold on. Hold at that. Oh, we need volume. Hella buzzy, but whatever. Uh-oh. We lost it. We had it. Oh. I'm no expert. Oh my god, this is so embarrassing. You guys heard that, right? Oh! Oh shit. I broke it. Oh, there it is. I don't know why it's so quiet. Oh wait, maybe you have to... Oh! Holy shit! Oh, I like this one. This one's good. Zero, zero, y'all. Shall we conjure the spirit? Demonstration on it years ago, he did say, Watch out for the brown sound. Water is life. True. You need to drink many glasses of water. Maybe we could do a jam with my dad. Show you've ever seen? Is this a show? So is your mom's last name Lewis then? Yes. Her last name is Lewis. Dream baby dream. Wow, that thing was intense. I'm just gonna put on my prize winner hat. This is from, can you guys name the movie that this is from? It's backwards, but can you guys call it? If you can, tell me what movie this hat is from. He's a director from Omaha. That's the only That's the only hint I'll give you. No, it's not. It says prize winner. Are you guys? Give me a break. No. Come on, it's from a great movie. Anyone? Come on. Okay, I'll give you a hint. Director from Omaha made a movie about where Laura Dern played a huffing addict. And so, no, not Wayne's World. Come on. So he made also a movie called Election. That's right, baby. You got it. Nebraska. Prize winner. The director is Emily Elbert. Do we have someone who's obsessed with Emily here? Johnny Cotton Shorts. Do you love Emily Elbert? What's going on here? She's amazing. I love her. Citizen Ruth. Yeah, that's the one with Laura Dern. What a great movie, right? Wow, what a great movie. I don't know if anyone's huffed, but geez. Not good for ya. Alexander Payne, Nebraska. Good job. Great. Mm-hmm. What's your favorite of his movies? About Schmidt? That might be my fave. I love when he gets into the hot tub with Kathy Bates. Misery. She's also great in that. What a great actress. Haven't huffed before. Never will huff. Good for you, Linda Ronstadt Jr. I don't think you should huff. I don't think anyone should huff. But Laura Dern huffs her ass off in this movie. It's a very great performance. Election is also great. Oh, Sideways. It's a tie between Sideways and About Schmidt for me. Sideways is, wow. Have you guys ever been up to the hitching post in Buellton where they shot Sideways? That's not where he melts down and like drinks from the Linda Ronstadt senior huffs too much. No, that's not nice. Take that back. Wild at Heart, that's a great movie, but that is David Lynch. Does anyone have the Criterion channel here? There's some really good stuff on there right now. There's a whole 70s horror category that's great. It's very, it's scary. It's really scary. Okay, so, wow, I've been yapping for almost an hour. I guess I'm gonna play another song for you. And, you know, eat some fish sticks, gluten-free. Gluten-free fish sticks, my fave. Well, it's been a real pleasure hanging with you guys. Can you play a song before I go to sleep? Sure. Anything for you, Elza Noah? Sofa King. Who is it? Sofa King. We need to talk about Kevin is on there right now. Oh, whoa. That movie's intense. I really like that movie. That director's awesome. Okay, so I hope you enjoy your fish sticks. Thank you, they're gluten-free. They're great. All right. Oh, let me get one thing, sorry. Try this one. It's the only other one I practiced. I'll practice more next time, I promise. I'm just getting back into it. I've taken a real break from people. Contact. You know? Weird times. Thanks so much. You guys are great.
The neighbors heard a scream.
There's nothing I can do. Cause I fell in love with you.
I love like
today. Well, everybody, thanks for joining me on 836. What a treat. Hope you enjoy your night tonight. And maybe we'll see you real time soon. I almost forgot. Bless this Modelo. Bless this Modelo. I bless your Modelo. Bless this Modelo. Good night, everybody.